Dear students, good morning to all. I welcome you to the third session in physics, motion in one dimension or motion in straight line. So in the previous session, we have discussed acceleration, velocity and all other things like path length and all discussed in first session. Now in this session, I will go to position time graph of some related to the acceleration. So position time graph already discussed, but not related with the, or in connection with the acceleration part. So it is also called XT graph. Okay, so position time graph or XT graph, position time graph or XT graph. Sometimes they give PT graph also. In one of the exams, they gave PT graph. P means position and T means time. So it is not a standard way of writing symbol. Actually, XT graph is correct. Now here, in terms of acceleration means, for positive acceleration, negative acceleration and zero acceleration, how can we plot the position time graph? So firstly, positive acceleration. So in the textbook, it is given like this, positive acceleration, XT graph for positive acceleration, A positive. Okay, how to understand this acceleration is positive for this? So velocity equal to dx by dt, I take here. It is the slope of tangent, slope of the tangent drawn to position time graph. Okay, so that is what velocity I can say. If I have to define acceleration in terms of velocity time graph, acceleration equal to dv by dt. Here I take dx by dt, slope of the tangent drawn to XT graph. Now if I draw the tangent to this line, so this point I draw a tangent, so this comes like this. So what is the slope of this line? That gives you velocity, instantaneous velocity at that instant of time. Okay, like this, at this time this, but the slope of this line I said negative, it is inclined to the positive x-axis, here time it is x-axis. So that inclination angle is more than 90 degree, tan theta is negative, slope is negative. And when the line is, the tangent is taken at the lowest point, here the velocity is zero. Velocity equal to zero at this point, at this instant of time, velocity is zero. Whereas if I take the tangent here, if I draw the tangent here, and the slope of this tangent at this point, at this instant of time, is positive. That means velocity initially here negative and it became zero, then it became positive, and as I go right side, okay, as I go to right side, so the velocity keeps on increasing because the dx by dt, what I say, slope, that slope value for this curve is continuously increasing because it is not a straight line, it is curve. Okay, now that's how we can understand. So initially slope was negative, then became zero, then positive. So this is the XT graph for the particle with the positive acceleration. We can also draw this way also. Okay, so like this also you can draw. So this also represents the XT graph with the positive acceleration. So here also the slope, if I draw the tangent here and find the slope, and here find the slope for the tangent, and as I go right side, as the time increases, position increases, so that the tangent, slope of the tangent increases, keeps on increasing as I go right side. So that means slope increasing is slope increasing means velocity increasing. Velocity increasing means acceleration is regarded as or considered as positive. So this graph or this graph for positive acceleration, XT graph for positive acceleration. Most important thing is whenever you plot the graph, you should know that quantities along the axis must be noted. So here position x we define or represent, okay, for the position, and t for time, it is must, without that there is no meaning for the graph. Now another situation is negative acceleration, negative, how can we plot the position time graph? A is negative means as given in the book, it is given like this. Okay, so how it is? So here if I draw the tangent to this XT graph, okay, at this point, at this instant of time, it has positive value of slope, and the slope continuously decreases, and at the highest point here, slope becomes zero. slope becomes 0 means velocity becomes 0. And when we go right side still further, the slope of the tangent becomes negative, negative and more negative. So when positive value tends towards negative value and more negative value, so we have to take that slope is decreasing, slope decreasing here, because initially positive value became 0, then it became negative. So slope decreasing, velocity decreasing. When velocity of the object decreases, I said acceleration is considered as negative. Acceleration is negative. This graph, or you can also draw the graph like this, okay, like this position time graph for a negative acceleration can be plotted. Importantly, note the quantities along two axis. This is for negative acceleration. Acceleration of the particle is negative, then velocity position time graph can be plotted this way. And if it is zero, acceleration is zero, then what can be the graph? This can be a position time graph can be like this. Okay, so here in this, the velocity is constant. Slope of position time graph gives you velocity, and is a straight line. For a straight line, slope is constant. When slope is constant, slope equal to constant, velocity equal to constant, because the slope gives, slope of a position time graph gives velocity. So velocity constant. When velocity constant, acceleration is zero. There is no increase or decrease in velocity, means acceleration is considered as zero. So this case, it can be many other ways we can plot. It can be this position time graph also. Here also straight line it is. The condition for acceleration zero, position time graph is a straight line. It can be inclined this way, or it can be this way also. Okay, so here also acceleration is considered as zero. Okay, because see here what happens, position time graph, the velocity is negative, but again constant value. Velocity is negative. Here first two cases velocity positive, slope is positive for these two lines. They inclined to the time axis with the angle between 0 to 90. So positive value of slope. Whereas this case, last case, what I have drawn here, velocity is negative, slope is constant, but velocity is negative. As position decreases, delta x value decreases, delta x value negative, x value decreases, delta x is negative. So delta x by delta t is negative. So velocity negative, velocity positive, velocity positive. Many other ways we can draw, but this is any one is enough. For zero acceleration, the position time graph comes this way. Next I am going to draw the velocity time graphs for various situations. Velocity time graph. So in physics, understanding, analyzing the graph is also a very important aspect when you consider the competitive exams, and in some theory questions also can be asked. But especially in competitive exams, the analysis or understanding the graph or a diagram is very useful or very important. So now I go to the velocity time graph. So velocity time graph is the graph plotted by taking velocity along y-axis and time along x-axis. That means the at various instants of time, at various instants of time, the particle's journey, we note down the velocities. With a set of values of velocity and time, we can plot the points and draw a curve. So advantage of having a graph is no need to represent the information of the journey in terms of a big table. Just one curve gives the idea or nature of the motion of the body, whether it is accelerating or whether it is moving with constant velocity, or it is moving with the negative velocity, or acceleration positive, acceleration negative. So any kind of that kind of information can be told about the journey of the particle. So now velocity time graph, velocity along y-axis, vertical axis, and time along horizontal axis, that graph is called as velocity time graph. So here the first case, velocity time graph for a particle at rest. So particle at rest or stationary, both are same, stationary. So in that first case, how is the velocity time graph, VT graph for that? So VT graph is the, again V here and T here, VT graph is the straight line coinciding with the time axis. Particle at rest or stationary means its velocity is zero. Velocity zero means that time axis only, or at any instant of time, value of velocity is 0. So it is coinciding or overlapped with the time axis. Now second case, particle moving with the uniform positive velocity, okay, or uniform velocity. Just if they ask uniform velocity, we draw the VT graph for uniform velocity. Okay, so uniform velocity, first case I take positive velocity, uniform velocity, positive velocity. Now here VT graph is like this. First uniform velocity, positive velocity like this. So here some constant value of velocity, it may be 10 meter per second. Okay, so 10 means this is the value, 10 meter per second. The velocity is constant, positive velocity. The same way we can say negative velocity. Okay, this is the time and this is the velocity along. So velocity is minus 5 meter per second. Minus 5 meter per second, v equal to minus 5 meter per second, like this. So it is below the time axis. Here it is above the time axis. So here also uniform velocity, here also uniform velocity. So that is a negative here, here it is a positive. Okay, so that is a difference. This is rest. Next case is uniform acceleration. Third case, uniform positive acceleration. I take uniform positive acceleration, shortly I wrote positive acceleration. So positive acceleration, how to understand this positive acceleration? To draw the graph. So positive acceleration means velocity continuously increases. Velocity is continuously increasing, acceleration is said to be positive. So the graph is the simplest graph I take passing through the origin only. So this is the graph where acceleration is constant. It is constant because the slope of this VT graph gives you the quantity called acceleration or instantaneous acceleration. So this is uniform positive acceleration where the initial velocity is 0. Now if I take a initial velocity is non-zero, it may start with the say 2 meter per second or 5 meter per second initially when it starts its journey. So in that case the graph will be like this. It is a straight line, okay, and here velocity keeps on increasing, positive acceleration it is, okay. So then it can be another way, it can be another way like this also. It can come or starts with some negative velocity also possible, okay. I can start from below the time axis, okay. So this kind of graph, let me show it here like this. It may go like this. The VT graph can be, so starting with certain negative velocity V naught, minus V naught, I will take negative velocity here, okay. So then here also the acceleration is positive, here also acceleration positive, here also, means in all the three diagrams what we observe is as you go right side, that is as time increases, time changes, velocity keeps on increasing, velocity increases, acceleration is positive. Then the fourth case is uniform negative acceleration. VT graph for uniform negative acceleration. Negative acceleration. So the graphs we can see negative A. So first graph, here initial velocity V naught I have taken. Okay, now first graph for this can be like this. Acceleration negative means slope should be negative. Slope negative means the graph should downward. So that means it should come this way. So this is the time and this is the velocity along y-axis. So as you go right side, the value of velocity decreases. I said velocity decreases, acceleration is negative. So it is negative acceleration. So this way we can plot, and then we can take this way also. Time, it starts from rest, and again negative acceleration means its velocity become continuously negative. So this is the origin here VT, and negative value of velocity, continuously it is negative velocity, acceleration also negative, velocity also negative. Here, here velocity positive, acceleration positive, only this much portion velocity negative. After crossing the this point, here velocity positive. Understand, try to understand the graphs. So here velocity is positive, but it may become zero, okay. At this point velocity becomes zero when the y quantity or the line touches the time axis, then it becomes zero. That quantity becomes zero, your velocity becomes zero. So here it starts with initial velocity, but moving with negative acceleration. Here it starts with the zero initial velocity, but moving with negative acceleration. So its velocity becomes continuously negative only, but here it is velocity positive, acceleration negative. So anything above time axis, velocity positive here. Here velocity is below the time axis, so negative values of velocity here. So at every instant of time, it is becoming more and more negative in this graph. So this way we can plot the various graphs. So in our discussion, we take uniform acceleration, variable acceleration is also there, but in our syllabus, in our first year syllabus, we are not dealing much with the variable acceleration. So at the most, positive acceleration, negative acceleration, zero acceleration, only three cases. Variable acceleration we are not dealing. Now what is the use or significance of velocity time graph? Significance or application, in exam questions may be asked like this: use, uses or applications of, or sometimes they ask importance of this VT graph. Applications of VT graph. So what inference we can draw, or what conclusion we can draw, or what information we can gather from velocity time graph? So first one is it describes, the VT graph of a particle describes the nature of motion. So it describes nature of the motion of the particle, nature of motion of particle. So what it means, the particle, whether it is accelerating. Suppose if I draw the VT graph for this, so then you can say the particle is accelerating with the positive acceleration, its velocity keeps on increasing. From that graph you can say, if I give the graph like this, then here I can say acceleration is negative, the particle is becoming slower and slower, its velocity becoming smaller and slower, it is slowing down and it may stop at certain time here. So this means nature of the motion, whether it is accelerated motion or whether it is constant velocity. Suppose if I give the graph, VT graph like this, then I can say particle is moving with the constant velocity. It may be combining all the three also. Okay, if I give the graph like this, you can say this kind of graph, if I give velocity time graph is given this way, then we can say at what instant of time, if I plot the time here like this. Okay, so I've taken here this number, I will take as say 10. From this graph I can say instantaneous velocity also, that is the second point I can say. Okay, nature of motion means it is accelerating, positive acceleration from 0 to 2 seconds, from 2 to 4 seconds it is moving with the constant velocity of 10 meter per second, 4 to 6 seconds it is moving with the decreasing velocity or negative acceleration. Here positive acceleration 0 to 2 seconds, velocity increasing gradually, here velocity decreasing. So that means another point is here, significance or use of, so instantaneous velocity, instantaneous velocity can be found from the VT graph. Instantaneous velocity of the particle can be determined or can be found from the graph, from graph, VT graph. Okay, can be determined from VT graph. That means at any instant of time, suppose at 1 second I want the velocity of this particle, so that can be say 5, because it is uniformly accelerated, 0 to 2 second velocity is 10. So at 1 second it can be 5 meter per second. So at any instant of time, the instantaneous velocity can be easily found from the VT graph. That is the second advantage or use of this VT graph. Then another one is very important, the slope. Slope of VT graph gives, slope of VT graph gives the acceleration of the particle, acceleration of the particle, slope of VT graph, slope value, value of slope. For this part slope is positive, constant. For this part slope is zero, that means acceleration zero, here positive acceleration. So we can find the slope here very easily, opposite side are 10, this one is 10 and this is 2, 10 by 2, 5. So acceleration is plus 5 meter per second square. Whereas from 2 to 4 second, velocity is constant. So acceleration 0. Okay, so acceleration 0. And here acceleration is negative. Decreases from 10 to 0. Velocity decreases from 10 to 0 means 0 minus 10, minus 10 by 2. So acceleration is minus 5 meter per second square. That means we can easily get the value of acceleration finding the slope of a VT graph for any duration of time. Then another important area thing is about the area under VT graph. Area under VT graph gives the displacement of the particle, gives the displacement of the particle during some interval of time. Displacement during certain interval of time. So from where to where, from which time to which time, we find the area under VT graph. Okay, suppose the particle goes like this. Okay, so like this. Now this area gives the displacement of the particle during say 0 to 5 seconds. Okay, if it is 10 here, okay, 0 to 5 seconds, what is the displacement in the particle? That we can calculate. What you have to do, area you have to find out. Area is for this triangle, half base into height. So 5 into 5 into 10. Okay, so half into 5 into 10, so 5 into 10, 50 by 2 is 25. So displacement of the particle is 25 meter. You can find out the displacement of the particle during any interval of time, not necessarily 0 to 5. You can find 0 to 2 second also. You have to draw the vertical line to get 2 second on the time axis, then find the area of that figure. Okay, so like that we can find out. So these are the four advantages, uses, significance, application, importance. Anyway, the question can be asked regarding this VT graph. Okay, so this points are very useful in next derivations and all. So that's why I wanted to list out the points. As such, it is not given in the NCERT book as collectively. So it is given in various parts of the explanation in this chapter. So but now I wanted these concepts to be discussed. Now here the point number 4, I said area under VT graph gives you the displacement of the particle. There is a result also. So result is, we have to prove this. The question can be asked, show that area under VT graph gives you the displacement of the particle during the interval of time. So result is area under VT graph, area under VT graph gives displacement, gives a displacement of the particle. Area under VT graph gives the displacement of the particle during an interval of time. For this one, simple diagram is given in the textbook. I go with the textbook only. Okay, so here time x axis and velocity along y axis, velocity or v, anyone is enough here, time or t. Now in the textbook they said particle moving with constant velocity, the velocity is given that u, whatever it is, and till a time t, from 0 to t, capital T, certain time, it is a horizontal line. Okay, so that means it becomes a rectangle. Yes, velocity time graph for this proving this result, velocity along y axis and time along x axis. Consider a particle moving with a constant velocity u. Constant means velocity is not changing, it is horizontal line, constant velocity. And then what we have to prove is area bounded by this VT graph with the time axis gives the displacement. Okay, so this is equal to u and this is equal to t. So from the graph, okay, so area of this figure is a rectangle actually. So area of rectangle, area of rectangle equal to area of VT graph, correct? So area of VT graph is, area of VT graph is equal to area of rectangle. This rectangle having a length here, xx I will take as a length, so that is 0 to t, so length is t, and height, length and breadth you can take, or length and height you can take here, so u, so that is length into height I can take, or breadth also we can take. So length into breadth, okay, length is t into breadth is say this one, or height is u, so ut. Okay, so this is the area under VT graph. Now observe carefully, u means velocity, velocity unit is meter per second, whereas the time unit is second. So when we multiply meter per second multiplied with the second, so per second and second cancel, so we left out with the meter, or if you apply dimensions also. So dimension of velocity is lt power minus 1, okay, in terms of dimensions we can say, and dimension of time is time only, t power 1. So dimension of this product u into t has the dimension of l, that is length. So length means it can be displacement also, okay. So here, so this is meter, okay. So related to this velocity, velocity time graph, we describe the quantity called displacement. So hence the product has the unit, u into t has the unit meter. So meter means it is a displacement. So this is equal to displacement of the particle during its journey. Particle during its journey, okay, during its motion. So that's about the result. Very simple. So area under VT graph is equal to area of rectangle. Length is t and breadth is u. So multiplying u and t. So observing the dimensions or units. So velocity multiplied by time. Velocity multiplied by time will have the dimension of length, or the will have the unit of unit equal to meter. That will have is that will be nothing but displacement. So therefore, the displacement is equal to area under VT graph. So with this idea or with this result, we can prove the equations, kinematics, the acceleration of the freely falling body, assuming the or neglecting the air resistance. Whenever objects fall, there will be opposition by the air, there will be viscous force which is opposite to the direction of motion of the objects. So whenever objects fall under gravity, gravitation force, that is towards the center of the earth, the direction of acceleration due to gravity is towards the center of earth. Acceleration is vector, it has got direction, okay. And one more thing is that if the particle is moving, the acceleration is positive when it is accelerating in the direction. If it is decelerating, negative acceleration is also called a deceleration, okay, or retardation. Now here acceleration due to gravity means how to understand. Whenever we drop the object, it will not remain here. Whenever we drop means I leave it, I will don't throw it downward, just drop it. So it will not stay there only, it will fall downward. So this is found by Newton long back, this law, gravitation law he gave, and other laws in mechanics also given by Sir Isaac Newton. So when the object is dropped, it falls towards the earth because of there is force, that force is called gravitational force. Every particle exerts gravitational force on the every other particle. But the earth, as it is very huge, it has got huge mass, because of that the gravitation force exerted on that particle by the earth is huge, so that it will fall towards the center of earth. And at what rate its velocity changes per unit time, that we can call acceleration due to gravity. So acceleration of the freely falling body under the influence of gravitational force is called as acceleration due to gravity. On earth surface, average value of acceleration due to gravity we take denote by symbol g, and the value is 9.8 meter per second square, average value. And it varies from equator to the poles, it is not a constant value, it is a variable actually, okay. Its value varies from equator, it is minimum approximately 9.78 meter per second square, and at the poles it is maximum. The value acceleration to gravity is maximum, say 9.83 meter per second square. So it is variable, it varies from place to place, and it varies with the altitude also. On the surface of earth we take maximum value, at the top of the hill it may have a little slightly lesser value, and inside the well, inside the mine also, the value of acceleration to gravity is lesser, little bit lesser. So on the surface it is maximum, and also at the poles it is maximum.
and the value of acceleration due to gravity varies from one planet to another planet. Like Jupiter, it is having greater value of acceleration due to gravity compared to Earth. Moon having lesser acceleration due to gravity because the mass of the moon is less. So acceleration due to gravity, in detail we study in a gravitation chapter. So it depends on the mass of that body which exerts the gravitation force. It may be Earth. If you are standing on the Earth, it is Earth exerting the force. And it depends another factor, that is radius of the body. Okay, so that two factors affect the acceleration due to gravity. And acceleration, we take negative always here. Acceleration of any freely falling body, we take negative, that is minus g, that is minus 9.8 meter per second square in all problems, numerical problems while solving. This important idea, why it is minus? It is conventionally taken, actually whenever objects fall, it is a downward motion. For this we have to take negative acceleration because the direction of motion is along negative y axis. Vertical motion upward, it is upward. Even the object is thrown upward, acceleration is downward only, because its velocity decreases. When velocity decreases, acceleration is backward, opposite to the direction of motion. When velocity increases, acceleration and velocity have the same direction. When velocity decreases, in such case, acceleration is opposite to the direction of motion. So here, whenever you throw the object upward also, its velocity decreases, so acceleration will come downward. Even the object is moving upward, the acceleration direction is downward only, as the velocity value continuously decreases and it stops at the highest point, or say we call maximum height. From there again it falls downward. So here acceleration is negative we take for any object, whether it is thrown upward or it is falling downward. Negative it is minus g or minus 9.8 meter per second square. Most of the times in the problems and all, they give the value acceleration to gravity. If it is not given, you have to take a minus 9.8. A value is minus 9.8, or take g value equal to 9.8. When an object falls from certain height, when it is dropped from certain height, suppose the object falls like this from certain height, so it is at that point its velocity is zero. Okay, then after 1 second, what will be its velocity? After 1 second of time, its velocity is minus 9.8 meter per second. I said acceleration equal to minus g equal to minus 9.8 meter per second square for freely falling body or any object thrown upward. The value of acceleration is same on Earth's surface. Average value we are taking. It may not be same at all places of Earth. It varies from pole to equator. So at the poles maximum and at the equator it is minimum. So now as it falls, after 1 second time, 1 second duration, its velocity changes by this number. Actually magnitude of velocity increases. It is zero when we drop the object. After 1 second journey, it comes to say 4.9 meter down. We can calculate how much displacement or what is the height by which it falls down. Okay. But velocity becomes minus 9.8. How to get that velocity? We have to go for the formula. So if you go for formula, V equal to V naught minus GT. Okay, so V naught is 0. When we drop the object, initial velocity is 0. Minus 9.8 into time 1 second. So velocity is minus 9.8 meter per second. Actually, the magnitude of velocity increases. Means it is moving faster. But it is downward direction. By convention, downward motion, the acceleration is downward and velocity is negative for downward motion, velocity positive for upward motion. But here see, minus 9.8, it doesn't mean that velocity decreases. Actually velocity, magnitude of velocity increases. You can see the raindrops falling or any object falling, it will be moving with a large velocity. Okay, but the magnitude is more only, it is falling with the greater and greater velocity in magnitude. But only minus sign says the direction in which it is moving here in one dimensional motion. Okay, so minus 9. After 2 seconds, means one more second, the velocity becomes minus 19.6 meter per second. Velocity becomes minus 19.6. Means the velocity after every 1 second changing at the rate by minus 9.8. So final minus initial, minus 9.8 minus 0 is minus 9.8, means acceleration is minus 9.8 meter per second square. Says that after every 1 second time duration, the velocity of the object which is falling freely in the absence of the upthrust or air resistance, or ignoring the air resistance, we can say it is a 9 minus 9.8. increase in the magnitude of velocity is 9.8, but the sign says the direction is towards negative y-axis, negative downward direction. Okay, so it is downward direction, so that's why after one more second it becomes minus 29.4 meter per second. In case of object thrown upward, okay, if you give say velocity minus 19.6 meter per second while throwing, after 1 second it's a velocity becomes 9.8 meter per second, and after one more second velocity becomes zero. That means when the objects are moving upward, the velocity decreases in magnitude because the gravitational force is downward, acceleration is downward. I said again, repeating, the acceleration of any object, whether going upward or falling downward, is always downward direction. Okay, that means the object decelerates, whether you throw upward or downward, it is falling. The value of the velocity becomes more and more negative, or it becomes lesser. That's all about this acceleration due to gravity. And few more points about acceleration due to gravity are like this. Suppose you throw or drop 1 kg object, you drop 2 kg object, or you drop 500 gram object. So whatever the mass of the object, they are all falling at the same rate, okay, ignoring the air resistance, I am telling. Then you may ask or a question in your mind, maybe if it is a leaf and the stone comes faster, or a feather and a leaf downward faster. Why? It is because of the upthrust provided by the air. If it is in vacuum, all the objects fall at the same rate. If you drop two objects, say feather and the stone, both will come or cover the equal distance after equal time. When they are freely falling, all objects, that means what I want to say is acceleration due to gravity is independent of the mass of the objects. It does not depend on the mass of the object. Okay, so that is provided condition is that the air resistance should be ignored. That's what, in vacuum all objects fall at the same rate, okay, but in air there will be air resistance or upthrust is provided by the air. Okay, so that's all about the acceleration due to gravity. The same idea, if you I can explain for the acceleration. Suppose the object starts from rest here, after 1 second its velocity is say 2 meter per second, after another 1 second velocity is 4 meter per second, okay, 4 meter per second, after another 1 second the velocity is 6 meter per second, like this at various instants of time. It is 1 second, 2 second, 3 seconds, like that. Its velocity increases at the same rate, 2 meter per second square. So increase in velocity here, 2 meter per second, here also 2 meter per second, here also 2 meter per second, assuming that uniform acceleration is there. So acceleration is how much? Acceleration is how much? Change in velocity, 2 minus 0 is 2 divided by 1 second. So 2 meter per second square. So acceleration in all the cases, because I said it is uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration, here velocity continuously increasing by equal value. So we can give the example as a uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration means the acceleration in which the change in velocity is equal in equal intervals of time. Okay, if the velocity of the object changes by equal amount in equal intervals of time, then the acceleration is said to be uniform acceleration. Non-uniform means either in direction velocity changes or in magnitude the change in velocity is not same. Okay, different. In 1 second time, equal intervals of time, unequal change in the velocity. Then such acceleration is non-uniform acceleration. Okay, so acceleration is vector quantity, has both magnitude and direction. So acceleration in this case is 2 meter per second square, which is uniform for all the journey. So from here to say here, 3 seconds. Okay, so that's the about example for acceleration. Okay, so then VT graph for freely falling body. Freely falling body, two special cases, falling body. Okay, VT graph for freely falling body. One is freely falling body means its initial velocity is 0. Initial velocity we denote it by V0 equal to 0. So this initial velocity 0 means
and acceleration, freely falling body, acceleration is negative. Okay, it is negative, that is minus g, okay, minus 9.8 meter per second square. That is the acceleration of the freely falling body. So how we can plot the VT graph for such situation? And after some time, velocity becomes negative. As the time increases, velocity becomes negative. Why negative? See, acceleration is negative means initial velocity only zero. So this is the case where the acceleration negative, slope is negative, inclined downward means slope is negative because angle made with the time axis is more than 90 degree. So this graph, this line is the VT graph for such situation, for freely falling body where the acceleration is negative and a velocity also negative. Velocity for freely falling body we take negative downward. Velocity with the sign convention when applied for downward motion, velocity is taken as a negative. Only upward motion velocity positive, whereas downward motion velocity negative. If velocity increases when we throw upward, its velocity decreases, so acceleration negative. When we drop object downward also, magneto velocity increases, but the value of velocity we have to take more and more negative. So that's why even falling body also velocity taken negative. Okay, so that is the as per sign convention, it is Cartesian sign convention. And one more situation, VT graph for another situation, when the object is thrown vertically upward, when the object is thrown vertically upward, how is the VT graph for such situation? When the object is thrown vertically upward means its velocity is maximum while projection. As it goes upward like this, its velocity continuously decreases. Here V naught is the maximum value when it is plotted at the when it is thrown from the ground upward, its velocity maximum at the ground. Then thereafter its velocity continuously decreases. So at any moment velocity is found, it is less than V naught, and at the highest point it stops, its velocity becomes zero, and then it starts falling downward in the same path. If it is thrown perfectly vertically upward, it falls downward. Now what happens to velocity? Velocity increasing in magnitude. Okay, here zero, it may be magnitude is 5 meter per second, 10 meter per second. So but direction is downward, so velocity is taken as negative for downward journey. So the graph will come like this. Okay, so here it is at the highest point where velocity is zero, then while the body falling downward, its velocity is taken as negative, but again acceleration of the freely falling body is a uniform constant at a given place, hence the graph would be like this. So this is the graph for representing the particle thrown vertically upward. For the particle thrown vertically or projected vertically upward, thrown or projected vertically upward, vertically upward. Okay, so this is the VT graph for such situation. These are the two special cases of VT graph in some exams and all they asked. So if the particle is thrown vertically upward, the VT graph will come like this. Initial velocity while projecting is maximum, then it decreases, velocity continuously decreases. When it goes to the highest point, its velocity is zero. So means velocity gradually decreasing from point of projection to the maximum height. Then when it falls downward, magneto velocity increases, but it is increasing in negative because direction is downward. So when it is say zero here, it is minus 5 meter per second, 10 meter per second, 15. Suppose it is thrown with the 30 meter per second going upward, it becomes zero after some time. Then while coming downward, it will be taken as negative, velocity will be taken as negative, hence it will be below time axis. So this is the second special case. Okay, so these graphs have been asked in the exams. Okay, so that's all about the two graphs. Dear students, I've discussed today in this session about acceleration and some part some velocity time graphs, all that. I hope you understood all these graphs. Little bit higher order mathematical thinking is required to understand the graphs, I said. So then I'll continue in the next session, that is equations of kinematics. I show the derivation, how to obtain those kinematics equation, and we'll discuss the problems in the upcoming sessions. Thank you for listening.